if you want it as bad as you want to breathe, if you really, really want it like you say you want it, you could have it. Don't believe the hype. Don't feed into it. If you work hard, you can't have it. It ain't nothing you can't have if you're willing to work for it. It ain't nothing you can't have if you're willing to persevere, if you're willing to stick in there, if you're willing to stay, if you're willing to fight. It ain't nothing you can't have. Listen to me, if you work for it, if you're willing to put in that sweat, that blood, and those tears, baby, I'm telling you, you can have what you want, be what you want, do what you want. Are you hearing me? It's yours. I'm coming. I'm telling you, it's yours. It's yours. You can have it. It's yours. You can do it. It's yours. You can be it. It's yours. If you're gonna be successful in life, you gotta understand that there's a sense of urgency, that there are only 86,400 seconds in a day, and you gotta not only operate in them, you gotta do it quick, you gotta do it fast, you gotta do it in a hurry. Why? Because there's somebody else who's on the same track you on. Somebody else who, listen to me, they're on the same path that you on. Listen to me, it's somebody else just like you trying to do it, and sometimes they're working just as hard as you're working. They're putting in just as much sweat, just as much tears, just as much blood. But you just got to do it what? You got to do it faster than they do it. You got to do it quicker than they do it. Are you listening to what I'm telling you? That's why I wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning, because if you're getting up at 6, you might be smarter than me. You hear me? You might. You might have more privilege than me. You might. You might have more resources than me. You might. But I'm going to get up earlier than you, and I'm going to do it quicker than you do it. I'm going to do it faster than you do it. So by the time you get up with all your resources, by the time you get up with all your privilege, by the time you get up with all your stuff, I've already finished the race. Are you hearing me? Every play is the drill. Every play is a 2-minute drill. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? Pick up the pace. You walking too slow. Pick up the pace. You moving too slow. Pick up the pace. If you want to finish sometime, you can't just finish. You got to finish fast. This ain't for the weak and the uncommitted. Are you hearing me? Success is not for the weak and the uncommitted. This is physical. Sometimes it's going to hurt. Sometimes it's going to be painful. Sometimes, listen to me, sometimes you're not going to be able to walk. Are you hearing me? But this is a physical sport. And if you want it, you got to go get it. You got to play hard for it. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? It's not for the weak and the uncommitted. Execution is worship. You got to get to a place that when you start it, you get through the middle of it, and you finish it. Are you hearing me? And not just finish, you finish strong. Listen to me very closely. Most of you, the reason why you'll never be successful is because you procrastinate. You procrastinate. You never finish stuff. You start and you never finish. Yup, it's hard. Yup, it's difficult. Yup, why? Because the process is weeding out the weak. It's weeding out the weak. And so sometimes you got to play hard. You got to play physical. You got to play tough, because the game itself is tough. The game itself is hard. But I know you got what it takes not to quit, not to give up, not to give in. Don't give up. Don't give in. You hang in there. You hang in there, because if you quit right now, you ain't gonna never see it. You ain't gonna never get it. If you hold on, everything you dreamed of, everything you envision, everything you work for, it's coming. But you can't quit or give up before you get it.
When it seems that nothing is happening, remember that the Father is about to bring it all together for you.
Let's go, man. Let's go. Y'all gotta be ready to play. Let's go, man. We have beat down ever since we came out here. We for real, man. We play for this. It's our country. It's our sport. Come on, my dog, man. We're ready to play. I'm goddamn busting. I'm gonna bust some truck and bust some more. And then after that, I'm gonna bust them again. Don't keep this up. They gon' kick back me down, and I'm gon' get back out. So we're gonna play, man. I die for my country. I die for all y'all. I die for my family. All the men who watch me.
There's not a person on my team in 16 years that has consistently beat me to the ball every play. That ain't got nothing to do with talent. That's just got everything to do with effort. Nothing else. 15 straight years. 12 Pro Bowls later. If you want numbers. I done saw all of it. And the only thing that's kept me around is my effort. So when you put on this, all I ever knew, because I wasn't a number one recruit, I wasn't a number one linebacker, I wasn't even an immediate guy. All I ever knew was effort will get me seen on tape. Effort will get me noticed to get to the league. Effort would one day take care of my mom and my kids. Effort, which is between you and you. Nobody else can give you effort. Effort is with inside, man. And I'm still grinding because the next kid is talking about he getting too old. Keep watching me if I am. Nobody ain't got to convince me of what I do. I do what I do because I do what I do. Because I'm built from something. And man didn't create it. Every one of you men in here have that opportunity, man. But ask yourself the question personally. How much time you really wasting? For real. Or do you really represent this? I represent it because it's all I had. It's the only brotherhood I ever been formed to. That's why when I see y'all perform on Saturdays, that is my peace. That's why I run to the hotels. I don't need to talk to nobody before my games. I just need to see what I once came from. I sat in these same chairs you guys sat in, man. I sat around the greatest athletes in the world. And then I found myself totally different because everybody was asking the question, who is this kid? I'm just sharing my story to tell y'all, every time you think somebody got it good, man, it ain't always good. Some people just make up their mind and they just grind and say the heck with it, man. Because sometimes that's all you can do. How much of our brains are we really going to use? I use mine to tell somebody today, September 11th, when I step on the field against the Pittsburgh Steelers, if that's what God's will is, there's no other man out there willing to give up what I'm willing to give up. I said that in 1993 when I said I wanted to be the greatest Hurricane. And the only thing that I got in the middle of all of that distance is the only thing that follows work is results. There's no other blueprint. I ain't got no other secrets to tell y'all today. I ain't come here for nothing else but to tell you, if you want to do something, work at it. You want a better relationship with God, work at it. You want to understand why pulling your pants up is important, why yes ma'am and no ma'am is important, why being in the meeting with complete silence when somebody walks in, because it's presence and essence that determines respect. So all we talking about, the power of respect is never to disrespect. That's why I was the first one sitting down in the meeting. I ain't got nothing to say. Y'all do y'all, I'm good. I got to listen. Something out there I need to grab from it. Sitting on the same football field at UM, 1993. And I made a quote. And that some people call controversy, I call it confidence. I said that I might be the greatest player to ever walk up out of the University of Miami. I did not say that because I thought I was better than everybody else. I said that simply because I was willing to put in the work to now be back here 18 years later and tell you the only brotherhood I still have.
You've got to say yes to your life. You've got to say yes. Yes to my dreams. Yes to me. Yes, I can make it. Yes, I can. Doesn't matter how many failures I've made. Doesn't matter how many mistakes I've endured. Doesn't matter about my defeats. Doesn't matter about what I've done.
sits on my chest in a shirt form. But the eye of that real hurricane is found in my heart. It's this where it all came from. Same path y'all walk. Same calves y'all going in. Same green tree y'all walking up and down. I had one pair of jeans in college for at least 2 years. At least 2 years.
Pain is temporary. It may last for a minute, or an hour, or a day, or even a year. But eventually, it will subside. And something else will take its place. If I quit, however, it will last forever. Y'all spoiled. Some of y'all spoiled. Just bottom line. Your parents have done everything for you. You never had to do nothing for yourself. You're spoiled. We're going to keep it real tonight. Some of you are spoiled brats. Every time you ever got in trouble, somebody in your house got you out of it. Every time you've done something you're not supposed to do, people say, Eric, your mother's a tyrant. You're right. She kicked me out. You're right. She's mean, but she developed a man because she put me out there and said, you're going to have to grow up. And some of you have never learned to grow up. And so every time something get hard, you quit, you call mama. I dare you to take a little pain. I dare you. I dare you not to go home. Somebody said, I don't go home, I feel bad. Go through it. You ain't gonna die. At the end of pain is success. You're not gonna die because you're feeling a little pain. We have gotten to a point where it's midterms and we're moving forward. The days of you getting money, I'm not saying we quitting, but I'm saying a day has got to go from external to internal. You have to give it everything you got. No more TV, no more parties, no more plan. If you don't have a 4.0, what you need to be doing is studying. Stop being this high school dropout. Stop giving up. Stop sleeping on the streets. Stop walking up and down Finkel Avenue like you ain't got nothing and get your GED. Stop being afraid to take a test.
I don't care about the fact I'm in a hole now. Doesn't matter about where I am. The last chapter to my life has not been written yet. If you judge me now, you'll judge me prematurely.
Stop being afraid to go to college because your daddy didn't go and your mama didn't go.
I haven't exposed all my stuff yet.
Stop being afraid and be the best Eric Thomas you can be. But listen to me, it's going to be hard. It took me 12 years to get a 4-year degree, but I got it. And guess what? On a degree, it don't have dates. So if it took you 4 and it took me 12, it don't show up nowhere.
I'm still in the process of transforming my life. I'm still in the process of becoming. Yes. Yes.
Question is, what are you going to do with your time? What drives you? Because I feel home. And when you're home, ain't much to say. Our work spoke for itself. That's where our swagger came from. Our swagger came from, we worked as a unit. I came to the University of Miami that was one mind, one set, one heartbeat. It was impossible to get to us. Because if you saw us somewhere, you saw 15 or 20 of us. Gotta stop leaving each other. Gotta stop hanging out without each other. The streets ain't chasing the same things you chase. There's many temptations out there. Just stay focused, man. As a team, though. As a team. That's all I knew when I was here. That's what kind of kept me focused. That I finally ran into a team. And you guys have that same thing. Because this you will never die. It'll never die. So it's up to you to carry that. It's up to you to carry that. And every Sunday, every Saturday, everything is talked about.
I gotta commit my very being to this thing. I gotta breathe it, I gotta eat it, I gotta sleep it. And until you get there, you'll never be successful in life. But once you get there, I guarantee you, the world is yours.